Well, it might be 60 years since the Seekers first performed together at a Melbourne café, but the stage lit up last night when the Arias paid tribute to their late, great, long-time lead singer, Judith Durham. Have a look.
Beautiful. And the band has a brand new album too, celebrating, can you believe it, their Diamond Jubilee. Keith Potger from The Seekers joins us live in the studio. How are you?
Thank you. Really well. And so lovely to be with you. Thank you very much.
What was it like being in the audience and hearing that tribute last night?
It was very emotional, actually. And the two singers, Casey Donovan and Dami M, did a fantastic job. That was a heroic note, wasn't it? That Casey hit
she
at the
end. She doesn't muck around, the old Casey. No,
that was fantastic. No, they did Judith proud, and it was a wonderful tribute from the industry to the group, and I was very impressed with the way it all came together.
And Judith's family especially wanted those two?
They did. They asked especially for Casey Donovan and Dami M to perform those songs, so it was really a great combination.
Oh, just
so
gorgeous.
Wonderful. Those women would have been so nervous as well, because
it is such an
enormous honour. In fact, you spoke to them on the red carpet at the Arias yesterday, Ange, but how does it feel having your music taken to a whole new generation?
Well, it's very heartwarming to know. And, of course, there has been a bit of brainwashing taking place because the parents bringing up their kids listening to our music. Morningtown Ride particularly, you know, that one. All the kids seem to know the chorus of that, and the parents, of course, as well. But, to go 60 years is really something that we're extremely proud of and extremely grateful for, because our fans, old or young, have stayed with us through the years, through the decades.
Well, this new album's your first album since Judith's passing in August.
Yes.
Was it a bit bittersweet to be working on it, or had she been working on it with you?
Oh, yes, Judith had been working on it with us. It was really rather lovely because, of course, no one knew that she was going to die. But she was very much part of the whole process, and the recording of the title track, Carry Me, was conducted while she was alive. It was a 1995 track, a demo that she had recorded of Bruce Woodley's song back in 95. And it had lain in the archives for all those years until historian Graham Simpson suddenly remembered that it was there and it came to light. And then Athel and Bruce and I put our instruments on and bass and the harmonies. And brought it to finish the track, and took it to Judith, and she was absolutely thrilled with the result. So
gorgeous.
You know, it was gorgeous that she had that connection, and it just came together in the most beautiful fashion. So we're very proud of that track. It's really, really incredible, and especially the lyric. It seems to be so connected. Poignant to her passing, yeah.
60 years is a very long time. What do you think has been the reason the music has endured for all those decades?
Well, I suppose there are several reasons. One must pay tribute to Tom Springfield, who died only 10 days before Judith died, and that was an extraordinary coincidence. But he was
Dusty Springfield's brother?
Correct.
Yeah,
Dusty's brother, and he was a very... a very humble person, and he wrote those incredible songs for us, I'll Never Find Another You, World of Our Own, Carnival's Over, and produced all those early songs. And, of course, to produce songs that live as long as they have takes a remarkable talent. And so The Seekers were his vehicle to present those songs to the world, and that's when people listen to this album, There are Tom Springfield influences scattered all the way through
Brilliant.
It. Yeah.
What I loved about last night was we were celebrating all the latest and greatest in Australian music while at the same time honouring some absolute legends.
Yes.
Judith, Olivia Newton-John, Archie Roach and so forth.
Yeah.
As someone who's had this incredibly and continues to have this incredibly long career in the Australian music industry, what advice would you give to some of those young ones coming through who busted through last night, like King Stingray and
Yes. Keep going. Never give up. Never give up. That's my advice. And that's what we did and that's what we are still doing, as it turns out. But, just keep going. If you have a dream, keep following that dream.
Yeah, good advice.
Well, thank you for chatting. You're much loved. Yeah. And the Seekers' Diamond Jubilee album, Carry Me, is out now. Keith, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Great to see you.
Thanks for having me. Cheers.